Okay, now let's quickly go towards our further discussion. Now we are going to discuss specific stone modifications. That means we are no more discussing general stone modification. We are going to discuss specific stone modification. So we are going to discuss acetylation. We are going to discuss methylation. We are going to discuss phosphorylation. We are going to discuss ubiquitination. And we are going to know at what positions these modifications are happening and at what type of enzymes are in fact involved in these modifications and what are the functions these modifications are performing. So this is a general map again about histone lysine acetylation. The box jo ki aapko red color mein nazar aa rahe hain, they have highlighted the lysine modification on histone. So we are going to discuss histone acetylation. So you could see the histone H2A could be modified at position 9 and 13. Histone H2B could also be acetylated at lysine 5, lysine 12, lysine 15 and lysine 20. Histone H3 could also be acetylated at lysine 3, lysine 9, 14, 18, 23, 27 and 36, and histone H4 is acetylated at lysine 5, lysine 8, lysine 12, lysine 16. One more thing which I wanted to tell you, you have to focus that the acetylation in histone context is only at lysine residues, and we know the lysines are positively charged amino acids. And these positively charged amino acids are neutralized by the addition of this acetyl group, which has a negatively charged. So this means one quick thing is that this neutralization of charge could affect the chromatin binding, chromatin formation, jo ki us jagah par maujood thi. Hum uske taraf ja rahe hain. So this is the general simplified reaction jo ki aapko yahan par nazar aa raha hai. If this is a protein and in this protein there is a lysine residue, and this lysine residue has this amino group, and this amino group on this lysine could be acetylated using through an enzyme which is through a substrate which is called acetyl CoA, and by the action of an enzyme which is called histone acetyl transferases, or generally acetyl transferases, and this will be converted into an acetylated protein or acetylated lysine residue, and this could be turned back, isko reverse bhi kiya ja sakta hai is pure process ko, by the action of another enzyme which is called histone deacetylases, and these histone deacetylases will convert back this modified or acetylated protein again to its natural or native protein, which is non-acetylated. So again, there is a table which tells you which amino acids are, which lysines are acetylated at. But let's know some of the techniques which you could use to study acetylation specifically. So you could go for SDS page analysis, and you know SDS page is a denaturing gel which will separate the protein of your interest according to your molecular weight and size. So you will have different proteins separated, they are resolved on the basis of molecular weight. So the more heavier proteins are present on the upper side of the gel, while lighter proteins are proteins with less molecular weight are present on the bottom of the gel. Please do also recall that the proteins on SDS page are resolved under the influence of an electric current, where proteins according to their mass to charge ratio migrate between negatively charged cathode towards the positively charged anode. That means in addition to the molecular weight of the proteins, charge on the proteins is also a factor for their migration speed on the gel. As we know that the non-acetylated proteins carry positive charge, while the acetylated proteins has lose its positive potential because of the addition of a negatively charged acetyl moiety, the acetylated proteins has lesser chance or tendency to stay at cathode as compared to the non-acetylated proteins. So there are multiple histone modifications which you could resolve. For example, in this case, for example, you could see this is histone H1, this is histone H2B, and you have more or less this one single band jo ki aapko yahan par nazar aa raha hai. But for histone H4, you could see there are multiple bands you could see here. For example, the 0 mean this histone H4 is not acetylated. 1 mean it is acetylated by 1 acetyl group. It is acetylated by 2 acetyl group. 3 mean acetylate, 3 acetyl groups has been attached to that. 4 acetyl groups has been attached to that. Just remember, we agar aapko previous picture yaad hai, to yahan par aapko pata hai na, stone H4 char different positions ke upar acetylate ho raha hai, 5, 8, 12 and 16 ke upar, and you could resolve that on gel, jo ki aapko yahan par nazar aa rahi hai, yahan par monoacetylated, diacetylated, triacetylated and tetraacetylated stone जो है वो आपको नजर आ रहेंगे. मैं आपको थोड़ा सा एक्सपेरिमेंटल बैकग्राउंड भी बताता चलूँ क्विकली. दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वाज मेड ऑन सम सेल्स जिनको ट्रीट किया गया डी एसिटाइलेज इनहिबिटर के साथ. एंड यू नो व्हाट आर डी एसिटाइलेजेस. डी एसिटाइलेजेस जब भी हमने बताया, जैसे हिस्टोन डी एसिटाइलेजेस हैं, ये हिस्टोन एसिटाइलेशन को रोकते हैं. सो दैट मीन इफ देर इज एन एसिटाइलेशन, दीज डी एसिटाइलेजेस आर हैव रोल to remove that acetylation. So there is an acetylation, deacetylation, deacetylases will remove that. So because you wanted to, you do not want this acetylation to go away, you do not want this deacetylation to be broken down, so you are using some inhibitors against these deacetylases so that your acetylation will stay there for longer period of time. So you wanted to stabilize this acetylation, so you have used this deacetylase inhibitor. So in this experiment, some deacetylase inhibitors were used in order to make acetylation permanent, and in order to make acetylation stay for a little bit longer period of time. And after the addition of these inhibitors, the cells were somehow digested at different time points. For example, soon after the addition of inhibitors, the cells were digested. Cells were digested after 2 hours of inhibition. Cells were digested after 6 hours of inhibition. So you see, these are the similar cells. Jinke andar, for example, apne bhi histone deacetylase inhibitor nahi dale. हिस्टोन डीएसिटाइलेज इनहिबिटर डाले हुए 2 घंटे हो चुके हैं. हिस्टोन एसिटाइलेज डीएसिटाइलेज इनहिबिटर्स डाले हुए 6 घंटे हो चुके हैं. सो यू कुड सी वन थिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, जो कि मैं आप लोगों की तरफ यहाँ पर जिसकी तवज्जो दिलाना चाह रहा हूँ, जिसके लिए मैंने पूरी बैकग्राउंड आपको बताई ताकि आप लोगों को थोड़ी सी मजीद आपकी समझ में भी आए. सो द रोल ऑफ डीएसिटाइलेज इनहिबिटर्स इज शोन हियर. आप दूसरे लफ्जों में देखिए, वो सेल्स जहाँ पर डीएसिटाइलेज इनहिबिटर्स नहीं है या 0 आवर्स में है, वहां पर आपको 0 के ऊपर बैंड हैवी नजर आ रहा है, थिकर बैंड. व्हाट डज दैट मीन? देयर इज लेस एसिटाइलेशन हियर. 0 मीन नो एसिटाइलेशन. 0 मीन नो एसिटाइलेशन. दिस इज नेटिव H4. बट एट 2 आवर्स दिस इज लाइटर, एंड एट 6 आवर इट इज इवन लाइटर. दैट मीन विद द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम or with the addition of histone deacetylase inhibitor, the non-acetylated histones are getting less and less and less. So where these histones are going? These histones are now shifting upward direction. So you see, these bands are getting thicker, these bands are getting thicker, these triacetylated bands are getting thicker, tetraacetylated bands are getting thicker. This is an indication that your inhibitor is stopping these enzymes jo ke remove kar rahe hain acetylation ko on histones ke upar. So this is a very interesting thing which I wanted to highlight you to remember that you could use SDS page, you could resolve different modified proteins on the gel. Secondly, you learn that inhibitors, deacetylase inhibitor, are in fact there to stabilize the histone acetylation, and with the passage of time unka impact badhta rehta hai. Second technique mass spectrometry hai, main detail mein nahi jaunga. You could get different peaks.
Sir, ek cheez.
Ji, please.
Sir, bands jo start hue wo jaise jaise deacetylation hogi to bands disappear ho jayenge. Aap ye yahan
हाँ, अगर नहीं, इसमें थोड़ी सी मैं आपको बताऊं, डीएसिटाइलेसिस का काम एसिटाइलेशन मूव करना है, ठीक है. सो यहाँ पर डीएसिटाइलेसिस नहीं है, यहाँ पर डीएसिटाइलेसिस बहुत ज्यादा काम कर रहे हैं, तो इसका मतलब है एसिटाइलेशन नहीं हुई, इसलिए 0 पे बैंड है, ठीक है. यहाँ पर डीएसिटाइलेसिस को रोकने के लिए इनहिबिटर मौजूद है, इसका मतलब डीएसिटाइलेसिस काम नहीं कर रहे, ठीक है, इसका मतलब है कि एसिटाइलेशन हो चुकी है, जो अगर एसिटाइलेशन हो चुकी है तो जीरो के ऊपर बैंड कम हो गया। जीरो मीन्स, जीरो का क्या मतलब है भला, इसमें मैंने क्या बताया था, दीज आर ऑल बैंड्स कोरेस्पोंड्स टू हिस्टोन एच फोर। जीरो मीन नो एसिटाइलेशन एट हिस्टोन एच फोर, वन मीन वन एसिटाइलेशन एट हिस्टोन एच फोर, टू मीन्स टू एसिटाइलेशन एट हिस्टोन एच फोर, थ्री मीन्स थ्री एसिटाइलेशन ऑफ हिस्टोन एच फोर, फोर मीन फोर एसिटाइलेशन ऑफ हिस्टोन एच फोर। सो इफ हिस्टोन डीएसिटाइलेज इनहिबिटर्स आर वर्क, इफ हिस्टोन डीएसिटाइलेजेस आर वर्किंग, if histone deacetylases are working, you will not get anything on 1 to 4 and you will get maximum thing on 4 0. And if histone deacetylases are not working, you will get maximum things on 1 to 4 and you will get little thing on 0. Understand?
Yes sir. Okay,
ab aapko samajh aayi baat? Zero se matlab acetylation hai jo ke remove hoti. Okay, quickly the next second technique you could use to discuss to highlight the acetylation is mass spectrometry. It will differentiate on the mass to charge ratio. So one lysine residue which is non acetylated and one residue which is acetylated could be separated out through this peak on the basis of their molecular size and charge, which will tell you that this lysine has got some, for example, extra weight and different charge than this non-acetylated, and you could separate them. I'm not going to discuss everything. You could go for auto radiography, radio labeling. Abhi kisi ne kuch der pehle fluorescence ka bhi zikr kiya. This is again something radio labeling jo ke fluorescence produce kar sakti hai. For example, if you have done some experiment in vitro and you wanted to know the acetylation status of some particular रेजिड्यू, ये एक एक्सपेरिमेंट है जो मैंने अपनी पीएचडी के दौरान किया किसी जमाने में, ये उसका डाटा है, इन विच वी वर इंटरेस्टेड ऑन लाइसिन 1079 एसिटाइलेशन एंड वी हैव समहाउ म्यूटेटेड दैट लाइसिन टू आर्जिनिन ग्लूटामिन एंड वी वांटेड टू नो व्हाट हैपन इफ वी म्यूटेट दैट लाइसिन इनटू आर्जिनिन ग्लूटामिन, वेदर दिस म्यूटेशन कुड हैव एन इंपैक्ट ऑन एसिटाइलेशन और नॉट। सो वी कट फाउंड दैट दैट चेंजिंग दिस लाइसिन रेजिड्यू there is how did we do that? We use the isotopes. So these are the carbon isotopes, C14 labeled isotopes jo ke use kiye in kaam ke liye, aur jiske baad in proteins ko auto radiograph ke liye develop kiya gaya, and we saw different band patterns jo ke aapko nazar aa rahe hain, and you could separate out different fragments which are acetylated and which are not acetylated. I am not again giving you much detail. Let's move on to the acetylation. What is histone acetylation? It is the addition of an acetyl group on lysine residue. Humne different points uske dekh liye. So different histone acetyl, different lysines in histones could be acetylated, and these acetylation could be one time, and these acetyl on one histone. And they could be multiple on one histone. So the enzymes who could do these acetylations, these are called histone acetyl transferases enzyme, and the enzymes which are removing them, these are called deacetylases enzyme. At this time, please be careful when you talk about acetylation. When we are talking about histone acetylation, we are concerned about N epsilon acetylation at lysine. Which acetylation? Amino epsilon acetylation, and which is different than alpha amino acetylation. These are two different things. So in order to understand this whole thing, you need to see, this is the, for example, the lysine residue. As we know that any amino acid consists of a central carbon atom which is called an alpha carbon and is a chiral carbon and is attached to four different groups. That is an amino group and an R side chain, and as well as with an hydrogen atom and an acid group. So this is the lysine residue. So starting from the alpha carbon, you could name all these carbon. For example, this is the alpha carbon, this is the beta carbon, this is the gamma carbon, this is the delta carbon, this is the epsilon carbon. So these are alpha, beta, gamma, delta and epsilon. So you see there are amino groups attached to this epsilon carbon and to this alpha carbon. So these are two amino groups. So when we talk about acetylation, we are normally referring to N epsilon acetylation. So here is the picture again. You could jo ki aapko dikha rahi hai. So this is the lysine, and it this lysine with the using with excess of acetyl CoA, CAT or histone acetyl transferases, isko lysine acetyl transferases bhi aajkal keh rahe hain. Hum isko acetylation mein acetylated lysine mein convert kar sakte hain. And you could see this acetyl group is attached to this now amino group jo ki epsilon position ke upar मौजूद है. दिस इज नॉट देयर इज अ कार्बन जो कि अभी आपको शो नहीं हुआ, लेकिन इस कार्बन को हमने एप्सिलॉन कार्बन कहा है, ठीक है, जो कि इसके लिए बड़ा जरूरी है. एंड द एंजाइम्स व्हिच आर कॉल्ड डीएसिटाइलेसेस दे कुड रिवर्स दिस ओवरऑल थिंग एंड दे कुड जनरेट एसीटेट एंड हिस्टोन. Quick overview of the enzymes. आपके लिए मैं बताता चलूँ. There are multiple enzymes जो कि इन सब किस्म की acetylation के लिए involved है. There are general two general types of major categories of histone acetylases. Previously we named them histone acetylases, but nowadays we say them lysine acetyl transferases, which is a generic term which tells that lysine present on any histone protein. That means non-histone proteins could also be acetylated. So not only the histone H3, H4, H2A, H2B, rather any histone protein could be acetylated. That is, non-histone protein could also be acetylated. There are two general categories of histone acetyl transferases. One is called type B histone acetyl transferases, and then there are type A histone acetyl transferases. Type B histone acetyl transferases are normally cytoplasmic in nature. So that is why they are called type B histone acetyl transferases. They contain a HAT1, and this histone acetyl transferase is important for lysine 5 and lysine 12 acetylation of histone H4. So you see, this is a specific enzyme jo ke sirf in two lysine residues ko acetylate kar raha hai. Then there is a type A histone acetyl transferases. So there was type B जो कि हमने पीछे देखी, जो कि साइटोप्लाज्मिक थे. टाइप ए एसिटाइल ट्रांसफरेसेस आर न्यूक्लियर, सो देयर लोकलाइजेशन इज न्यूक्लियर. दैट मींस दे आर प्रेजेंट विद इन द न्यूक्लियाई. देयर आर थ्री डिफरेंट फैमिलीज और सॉरी फोर डिफरेंट फैमिलीज ऑफ टाइप वन हिस्टोन एसिटाइल ट्रांसफरेसेस. वन आर कॉल्ड जी नेट फैमिली व्हिच इज कॉल्ड देन मिस्ट फैमिली, P300 CVP फैमिली, एंड देन देयर इज अ रेट 109 फैमिली जो कि आपको नजर आ रही है. हर फैमिली के अंदर डिफरेंट मेंबर्स हैं. सो जी नॉट फैमिली कंटेन्स टू डिफरेंट मेंबर्स व्हिच इज कॉल्ड GCN5 एंड PCAF. मिस्ट फैमिली कंटेन्स MOS, SAS2, SAS3, ESA1 एंड MOF प्रोटीन, व्हेयरएज CVPP300 कंटेन ऑफ कोर्स CVPP300 प्रोटीन. मोस्ट ऑफ दीज histone acetyl transferases or most of these lysine acetyl transferases contain a bromodomain. And remember what bromodomain do? Kya karti hai bromodomain bala? Most of these proteins contain bromodomain that can specifically identify and bind to already acetylated protein. That means these protein has not a simple role of doing acetylation, but they could also be recruited by proteins that are already acetylated. That means the further crosstalk mechanisms could also be possible, and moreover these proteins could also regulate themselves through an auto acetylation process. Other than that, there are other histone acetyl transferases which have been identified. In humans, there are 22 different lysine acetyl transferases till today which have been reported. These 22, number 22 means there is a lot of variability what these enzymes could do. For example, there is not one enzyme, rather there are 22 enzymes. So that means these 22 enzymes could be specific against certain modifications of histone at certain loci. So this is a general structure. Aapko remember karne ki zarurat nahi hai, but it's just to give you that what are the similarities and what are the differences in all these histone acetyl transferases. They generally have the same role, more or less. They have these, some of them contain some specific domains which are present in all of these proteins. For example, they structurally they are conserved to one another, so they have all bromo domain we have already seen, or in catalytic domain, jo acetylation domain hai, wo bhi aapko same nazar aayegi. If you could see these beta sheets jo ki aapko nazar aa rahi hai, and then these helices जिनके दरमियान ये बीटा सीट्स मौजूद है, इसको आप कह सकते हैं बीटा टर्न, बीटा हेलिक्स, बीटा, जो आपको हर एक के अंदर मौजूद है, जो कि दूसरों के अंदर विच गिव्स देम सेंस दैट दे आर एवोल्यूशनरी कंजर्व. बट ऑन द अदर हैंड दे हैव सीक्वेंस डाइवर्जेंस, दे आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईच अदर बिकॉज दे हैव डिफरेंट सीक्वेंसेस. They have different catalytic mechanisms. Why are catalytic mechanism different? Because some could require some metal ions to work, and some do not require that metal ions to work. And they have different substrate molecules to which they are binding. Similarly, we have histone acetyl transferases ko dekha. There are other enzyme, other portion of this overall story is the histone deacetyl transferases, which are called deacetylases. They are in fact they have a role, they have a responsibility to deacetylate the histone protein. This cartoon tells you that in acetylation form, the chromatin is more or less relaxed, but in deacetylation form, the chromatin is compacted. So that means acetylation has a more pronounced role in histone expansion, and whereas the deacetylation has a role in histone compaction. So you see, so there are different deacetylase enzymes jo ke involve hain histone deacetylases ke liye. There are four different classes of histone deacetylases which are known to date. So these are called class 1 histone deacetylase, 2, 3, 4 histone deacetylases. And class 1 histone deacetylases contain, in fact, deacetylases which are like RPD3 histone deacetylases. RPD3 is a yeast histone deacetylase transferase. Deacetylase, because they were initially known, so all of the rest deacetylases were somehow named after their presence. Similar, those deacetylases that were similar to these RPD3, they are known as RPD3 like histone deacetylases, or now we can say them class 1 histone deacetylase. They contain HTAC 1, 2, 3, and they are most cell types can are present hai, and normally they are present within the nucleus. Then there are class 2 histone deacetylases, which are HDA1 like histone deacetylases. Again, HDA1 is a yeast histone deacetylase because we know originally know them from yeast, so that is why all those histones which histone deacetylases which are similar to that, they are called HDA1 like histone deacetylases. The name examples are HDA, HDAC 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, HDAC. So what is the specification? They could be present within the nucleus, and they could be present outside the nucleus. So they could have cytoplasmic as well as a nuclear location. So their localization is not certain. So they could shuttle between one and the other thing. Then there are class 3 histone deacetylases. These class 3 histone acetylases are SIR2 like histone deacetylases. SIR is a side, again, this is a yeast deacetylase. And in other organisms, these are called NAD dependent histone deacetylases. Then there is a serotin families, which is very important in most of the डेवलपमेंटल प्रोसेसेस एंड कॉग्निटिव न्यूरोसाइंस के अंदर हम इनको बड़ी बहुत से जो इम्पेयरमेंट्स हैं उनके अंदर इनका रोल हम आइडेंटिफाई करते हैं. दे आर सिर टू लाइक डी एसिटाइलेसिस सीरोटिन्स, ठीक है. सो दीज आर डी एसिटाइलेसिस. देन देर इज अ क्लास फोर हिस्टोन डी एसिटाइलेस विच शेयर्स सीक्वेंस होमोलॉजी विद क्लास टू जो इसकी तरह के हैं, इनको केडक्स भी कहते हैं. ह्यूमन्स के अंदर अंटिल नो 18 different lysine deacetylases has been identified, whereas or mouse ke andar bhi itne hi mal chuke. Inke ilawa plants ke andar ek special type of deacetylase maujood hai jisko HD2 type deacetylase kehte hain. So in plants there is specifically another histone deacetylase which is called HD2 histone deacetylases. So normally these terms jo ke deacetylases maujood hai, they are specific to scientific research knowledge, but nowadays lots of pharmaceuticals are using these names, are using these materials to produce different types of cosmetics. So just one thing which I wanted to tell you, please be careful when using such type of material, because not all of these materials are healthy. Of course they are not documenting it like this, but they could have side effects. Most of the skin diseases could be possible through this, because they are potential epigenetic regulator molecule. So for example, there are available serotonin skin creams. Of course the name tells you that you will always remain young, so it is against aging. But these roles has not yet been determined so clearly. So you cannot say it's a black and white thing now. So that is why these cosmetics are not that much sure ki aap inko use kar sakte. So be careful while using these type of thing. This is just a picture to compare the structure of histone, different classes of histone deacetylases. So you could see the class 1, class 2. And class 2A, class 2B histone deacetylases, you could see they have certain domains, structural domains, which are present in all of them. So these are the catalytic domains. So you to somehow they should share certain type of sequence homology. But some of them have different catalytic activities than others. For example, some require zinc positive two ion to perform their function. For example, the class 1, 2, and 4 deacetylases do not work without zinc metal. But on the other hand, other enzymes do not. For example, there are other enzymes which require NAD, not zinc, but NAD dependent deacetylases. For example, class 2 deacetylases. Okay. This is a very important slide which I wanted to tell you and show you and tell you why it is important to please be careful when to perform different type of to develop your feeding habits. So in this picture you see in the center your theme under discussion, which is acetylation and deacetylation. So you see lysine, it got acetylated. And this acetylated may be reverse again to that. And there are enzymes jo ke lysine acetylation kar rahe hain. There are enzymes jo ke deacetylation kar rahe hain. So there are two types of enzymes jo ke yahan par. So this is a kind of tug of war. Both of these points are doing. So in this picture, which is a very important, very beautiful picture, you are looking at certain chemicals which are inhibitors of either acetyl transferases, are they are inhibitors of deacetylases. So they could be inhibitors of lysine acetyl transferases, and they are inhibitors of histone deacetyl transferases. So for example, the example of these inhibitors for lysine acetyl transferases are curcumin, plumbagin, leunosine, garcinol, and anacardic acid. So this is the lysine acetyl transferase inhibitors. And these inhibitors are enriched in these types of foods. For example, cashew nutshell, which is jisko aam zubaan mein hum kaju kehte hain, and plant leaves, they are rich in these inhibitors. So that means if you use excess of these materials, you are somehow blocking your lysine acetyl transferation. You are somehow blocking your acetylation process. On the other hand, there are enzymes, there are molecules like SFN, butyrate, AMD and D, and MCP30. These are inhibitors of histone deacetyl transferases. And they are rich in, for example, cruciferous vegetables, the vegetables, they like turnip, jinke andar hai, jinke andar cabbage hai, cauliflower hai, different types of cruciferous vegetables, garlic, and then bitter melon, jisko bitter grout bhi kehte hai, karela, aam zuban mein urdu mein hum kehte hai jisko, unke andar inki excess maujood hai in chemical ki. That means if you use those chemicals in excess, these food materials in excess, you are adding up more deacetylase inhibitor. So that means you are promoting acetylation. Addition of deacetylase inhibitor means promotion of acetylation. On the other hand, addition of acetylase inhibitor means promotion of deacetylation. So this is a very important thing which I wanted to tell you, and I have taken this data from a paper, jo recent paper, jo ke ek nazar aa raha hai. So what is the outcome? So these processes, deacetylation and deacetylation, could be important for apoptosis, cell cycle arrest, anti-infection, anti-inflammation, anti-ROS, and other mechanism. And you see nowadays anti-inflammation is a very important thing. Infection bhi hamare liye badi important ho gayi aaj ke zamane mein, khaas tarah jab se ye COVID pandemic aayi hai. And you wanted to make these things in a balance. And if you have these things in balance, you are in a healthy state. If you have unbalanced these things, you are in an unhealthy state. So it is very important to choose your feeding habits carefully, because you do not want to mess up with your epigenome untimely. Agar timely na kahun to untimely aap iske sath mess karna nahi chahenge, because if you have messed that up untimely, you will completely destroy everything. So please be careful when you see. So this picture, this slide is in fact to tell you that how important is histone acetylation.